हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू इजी इंग्लिश एक्सप्लेनेशन बाय पूजा जोशी. दिस इज़ द सेकेंड वीडियो सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 9 NCERT बिहार बुक एंड लेसन नंबर 9 द बॉन्ड ऑफ लव. सो इन प्रीवियस पार्ट द फर्स्ट पार्ट वी हैव सीन दैट अ राइटर गेट्स अ बियर कप वेरी क्यूट लिटिल बियर कप as by mistake his friend shoots the beer cup's mother and now he is after the beer cup to capture him. Let's see further. Paragraph number 4. I ran up to it to attempt a capture. It scooted into the sugarcane field. Following it with my companions, I was at last able to grab it by the scruff of its neck. While it snapped and tried to scratch me with its long hooked claws. So the writer here says that he tried to run to that bear's cub to hold him, to catch him. But it just scooted. Scooted is just slipped and ran very, very fastly from his hands. Then he ran towards the sugarcane field. Writer tried to follow him, run after him with his companions, and then at last writer was easily able to grab him by the scruff of its neck. Scruff means, you know children, that the back portion of the neck. It snapped, it tried to move away and push hard the writer, and the bear's cub scratched the writer with its long hooked claws. We put it in one of the gunny bags we had brought, and when I got back to Bangalore, I duly presented it to my wife. She was delighted. We put it in one of the gunny bags we had brought, and when I got back to Bangalore, I duly presented it to my wife. She was delighted. She at once put a colored ribbon around its neck, and after discovering the cub was a boy, she christened it Bruno. So here the writer put it in one of the gunny bags which we store grain. Like I'll show you the picture of gunny bag. Here see gunny bag. And now I'll show the picture of gunny bag. And when he presented it to his wife, his wife was very, very happy to see. Here, see. Can you see this picture of the gunny bags? Yes. Now coming back. Yes. Now let's see further what happened. His wife was very, very happy and delighted to see that small bear cub. She was very happy and she put a colored ribbon around its neck. And she discovered that the baby was a boy. She named it, christened it means, named it Bruno. Now paragraph number 6. Bruno soon took to drinking milk from a bottle. It was but a step further, and within a very few days, he started eating and drinking everything else. And everything is the right word. For he ate porridge made from any ingredients, vegetables, fruits, nuts, meat, especially pork, curry, rye and rice, regardless of condiments and chilies, breads, eggs, chocolates, sweets, pudding, ice cream, etc., etc., etc. As for drink, milk, tea, coffee, lime juice, aerated water, buttermilk, beer, alcoholic liquor, and in fact anything liquid, it all went down with relish. So here in sixth paragraph we will know that what all things he used to eat. Firstly, he started drinking milk from a bottle. Then within very few days it grew up well and it started eating and drinking everything else. Everything in the world was eaten by him, whether the thing may be eatable or whether it may not be eatable. Everything, as the writer says, is the right word. These are the things which was given by the writer to him to eat. vegetables, fruit, nuts, meat, especially the pig's meat, pork, curry and rice, regardless of the spiciness because of condiments and chilies. Then bread, eggs, chocolate, sweets, pudding, ice creams, everything he used to eat and everything he used to drink. Tea, coffee, lemon juice, ice cream, that soda drinks, buttermilk, beer, alcoholic liquor, etc. Everything. He ate with a relish. Relish means to eat anything with extreme interest. To eat something, enjoying that food. Number 7th paragraph now. The bear became very attached to our two Alsatian dogs and to all the children of the tenants living in our bungalow. He was left quite free in his younger days and spent its time in playing, running into the kitchen and going to sleep in our beds. Here what happened? The bear soon became very attached to two Alsatian. Alsatian is a breed of dogs, big dogs. He was very attached to the children also of the tenants. Tenants means those who occupy somebody else's rooms or house, buildings and pays rent for it. Okay. Then he was very attached to them and he was playing, was left free as he was young. Though wild animal, he was young. So he was left free in his previous days when he was very very young. And even he used to sleep in their beds. One day, 8 number paragraph, one day an accident befell him. I put down poison, barium carbonate, to kill the rats and mice, and that had got into my library. Bruno entered the library as he often did and he ate some of the poison. Paralysis set in to the extent that he could not stand on his feet, but he dragged himself on his stumps to my wife, who called me. I guessed what had happened. Of course, off I rushed in the car to the vet's residence. A case of poisoning, tame beer, barium carbonate. What to do? Okay. See here, the explanation follows of 8th paragraph. One day, one accident, one bad happening happened with him, befell on him. Like the writer had put down some poison to kill the rats which had entered the writer's library. And the poison was in the form of barium carbonate. It was a chemical named barium carbonate. Bruno entered the library as often he used to enter and he saw and everything he used to eat without knowing that is this eatable or not. So he ate some of the poison and paralysis attacked his body. He was not able to stand on his feet or not able to even breathe properly, but he somehow managed to drag on his knees and feet and he was able to drag himself to the writer's wife. And writer's wife then instance called her husband and her husband rushed to him to a vet's doctor's residence. That is, a vet means a doctor for the animals. And he saw that, okay, it's a case of poisoning of a tame bear and barium carbonate has been eaten by him. So now what to do? What treatment should I do? Paragraph number 9. Out came his medical books and a feverish reference to index began. What poison did you say, sir? Barium carbonate. Ah, yes. B-A-B-A-R-I-U-M. Barium salts. Ah, barium carbonate. Symptoms, paralysis, treatment, injections of... Just a minute, sir. I'll bring my syringe and the medicine. A dash back to the car, Bruno still floundering about on his stumps, but clearly weakening rapidly. Some vomiting, heavy breathing, and with heaving flanks and gaping mouth. So here's the explanation of 9th number paragraph. The vet, the doctor of the animals, he took out his medical books and he started a feverish reference, a slow reference to his medical dictionary, and he asked about the poison, that which poison was taken in by mistake by Bruno, the beer cub. Then writer answered that barium carbonate. He took barium carbonate. Ah, yes. Then the doctor, he searched in the dictionary like BA, barium salts. Ah, okay. Then he saw the symptoms, paralysis, treatment. Yes, I have to give him injection. So I'll just bring my syringe and the medicine. And rush back to the car was there. And Bruno was still floundering about on his stumps. But he was weakening rapidly. He was growing weaker and weaker by minute and minute. His breaths were very, very heavy. He was not able to breathe properly. He was struggling for his breath. And he had a gaping mouth. He had to keep his mouth open to have the breath. So let me show you the meanings of the words. Here, see the meaning of floundering. Then just look here to the meanings. To flounder means struggle or stagger clumsily in mud or water. He was just struggling. He was just rotating here and there to struggle himself to have the breath. He was in very, very short of breath. He was having heaving flanks. Heaving means, see here, a chronic respiratory disorder of animals of the horse family caused by allergies and dust. It's like a breathing disorder. See here, heaving flanks. Flanks meaning the side of a person or animal's body between the ribs and the hips. Maybe the right or left side of body of people, such as army, naval force or soccer team. Means his sides were heaving. Heaving meant not able to breathe properly. So coming back here, yes, he had heavy breathing, some vomiting. He was still able to struggle on his stumps, but he was getting worse minute by minute. Hold him, everybody. In goes the hypodermic. Bruno squeals. 10 cc of the antidote enters his system without a drop being wasted. 10 minutes later, condition unchanged. Another 10 cc injected. 10 minutes later, breathing less stertorous. Bruno can move his arms and legs a little, although, but he cannot yet stand yet. 30 minutes later, Bruno gets up and has a great feed. He looks at us disdainfully, as much as to say, what's a barium carbonate to a big black bear like me? Bruno is still eating. Here's the explanation of 10th paragraph as follows. Hold him, everybody. Everybody has to hold because they don't understand that they are being injected and they should not move a lot. They should allow the doctor to inject. So we have to catch an animal properly so that injection medicine inside the injection can well enter the body without being wasted. So he was given, in goes the hypodermic. Just the region beyond that, beneath the skin, is hypodermic. Hypodermic, and Bruno squeals. He makes very pitiful noises because of pain. He just hypodermic. Here, see the meaning of hypodermic. It's relating to the region immediately beneath the skin. then the breathing became less stertorous, means less noisy and less painful and labored. Then when he got all right, first he was given one injection, then after it was waited, then there was no change. Then another dose or another injection was given to him, so that the dosage can be increased. So then little bit he was able to move his hands and legs, but still he was not that much okay. But then after half an hour he felt better and he ate very nicely. He had a great feed. He had ate a good amount of food. So now when he was okay, when he was completely recovered from that, he was looking at the writer disdainfully. Disdainfully means somebody is looking at us in that way as if we are not taking care of them or not giving importance to them just because they are inferior, they are very low to us. Here you can see the meaning. Disdainfully is something refused with contempt because it's beneath you. If someone makes you a dish of food that you think looks not good or gross and you refuse to eat it, this is an example of when you regard the food disdainfully. If somebody prepares food for you and even if you like it or don't like it, you should at least praise the food or have some. And you should maintain the respect of other. Here see, disdainful means to dislike something or someone because you think that they are unimportant or not worth your attention. And now you can see the meaning of squeal. Squeal means to make a long, very high sound or cry. Now coming back. See here. Now Bruno is all right again, he's back to normal. And that's all for the second session of lesson number 9, the bond of love, part number 2, second part that is. Hope to see you again as early as possible. Bye bye.